house, so I feel sensitive to be not able to talk about everything I want. So I will show first the most interesting results that resonate best with what parts and this always discussed today. So in this project, my first my initial motivation was just to test for measurement the variance of chase layers and quality layers. These two are just subdimensions of the immensity various figures, so I will not explain them in details because it was done by other presenters both yesterday and today. So, but in this respect, my results are quite encouraging and not very provocative. I found that both for choice values and quality values, partial scalar invariance across EVS countries that participated in the last round of this EVS is a plausible assumption, more or less plausible, so this result is quite encouraging and promising with respect to this indices and with respect to non-invariance based criticisms of immensity various paradigm. So I will move to other empirical findings that's probably more provocative and more interesting. And I want to start from the very end of my presentation because it resonates well with what Chris said about how means and variances on closed scales affect goodness of fit of factor models. So on this slide, well, on this slide I present this argument in a very outdated form. So the basic idea I think is presented in a correct way. So the idea is that on closed scales, which are overwhelming in computational theory research, extreme means lead to smaller variances or standard deviations, and this leads to smaller factor loadings, lower factor loadings, and therefore to worse fit indices for countries with CFA models. And Chris showed a beautiful slide in which on which he juxtaposed country mean scores on country standard deviation on the EVI and country-specific measures of dimensional cohesion of the signals. Well, my result, and you saw that the link was truly positive. Higher variances, better fit measures. So, well, my results that I drew on the last release of the EVS 2017 seem opposite. For example, four choice layers. Here you can see four figures. On each figure, I plot country mean scores on choice versus four popular CFA goodness of fit measures. On the top panel, you see the results for CFA and CLI. Higher values corresponds to better fit. And on the bottom panel, you see the results for MCA and SRMR. Lower values indicate better fit. So what we see here, if we think in a linear fashion, we see that higher means indicate better goodness of fit for country-specific CFA models. But you can also see that the linear approximation may be not the best choice, and there is an obvious reverse to shape relationship between country means and goodness of fit measures, which indicates that extreme means actually lead to better goodness of fit, not vice versa. When it comes to variance, well, we see that there is almost no relationship between variance, average IT variance, and goodness of fit measures. So, what about quality? So, for quality, we see that, again, the linear relationship between goodness of fit and average IT mean is positive, higher means better fit measures, but still there is evidence that non-linear approximation may fit better, and indeed extreme means lead to better fit measures. And finally, variance versus fit for equality. Here we see that larger variances So in this respect, I do not support the low variance for fixed theaters. However, I should recognize, I should acknowledge that my sample is much smaller than the sample of which basic results, but still there is some contradiction between two results. So can we do that? Okay, great. So another interesting result that I want to show flats the cross-level invariance of these two sub-indices of elements of waves. So cross-level invariance is much less known than cross-national invariance. However, it is important in one respect. One of the key theories proposed by Chris and Ron, sorry, Joyner and Adam Wilson in 2016 is that we basically misunderstand the level of aberration in density waves. And they think that waves are essentially country-level constructs. Well, they present this sentence as purely conceptual frame. However, there are some empirical tools that can allow us to distinguish between two interpretations. So two basic interpretations. So the most popular, while it may be misleading interpretation of density waves, is that it is both individual level construct, because we can easily imagine that people may have different attitudes in this regard, and therefore we can claim that different people have different things. However, another is also country level construct, because well, countries are different in the various in this average values or in the value of dispersion and so on. Another claim is that values are purely country level construct, and what we see at individual level is just reflections, not truly individual traits. Well, this can be tested. Unfortunately, I have no time to discuss in detail all methodological details, so I will come to detail to results in the video. So here, first of all, just a very important preliminary statistics. ICC or interclass correlation coefficient shows for each item in this table the amount of variance that is explained by country level variation, not within country variation. And we see that for all items here, ICCs are fairly large. So actually, ICCs larger than 0.05 are considered substantial. And here we see that they are much more larger. So this clearly suggests that sensitive values has a very strong between country and company. So what about comparison between both level model and only between level model? Here is the results for choice. Well, you have you see six different models. Two-level interpretation model is represented by models labeled as equal loadings and invariance and partial invariance. The between only model is represented by the label shared. And also, I guess it's a model that is a combination of the two, which is called shared plus the fitted. Well, here we see that two best fitting models, so these models are not level CFA models. And I should warn you that the issue of model fit assessment for multi-level models is not very well studied, and it is unclear still on which measures we should look to understand which model is better. But the current methodological consensus is that the most important measure, if you think about explanation of between level variance, is SRMR between. So I suggest to look at this now. So according to this result, two best models are sharing models, that is between only, and unconstrained factor model. It is a configurable model that is, it assumes that the construct method values exist at both levels, both at the individual and country level. However, this model suggests that we can, okay, great sense, that we can't compare individual level scores and country level scores. They reflect different influences and different kinds of variation. The same is true for equalities. Again, two best models are shared and unconstrained. Well, unconstrained model is not very interpretable. problems of people at different levels, but still, this evidence suggests that between level interpretation deserves attention. So, for quality, the difference between indices for between two-level interpretation and between-level interpretation are not so drastic as for choice model. So, here we should decide probably based on the optimal interpretation, but still, it provides some empirical support for procedural theories about country-level interpretation of landscape events. So, basically, that's six. Unfortunately, I can discuss my results in greater details, but thank you for attention and hope for your comments. Sophisticated kinds of